Yeah, so our today's topic, that is scatter graphs. So scatter graphs, and it is a type of correlation, beta. Okay, that means so when you would like to relate one value to another, okay, or one data to another data, then that is the type of correlation. Okay. Understand? So here that in this topic, that scatter graphs, so that means in this topic that we will study about the plotting of a scatter graph and its line of best fit. Secondly, that we would like to understand the idea of correlation. Also will be understand the positive and negative correlation. Okay, it's a very very important concept, correlation. Okay. Yes, also we would like to be able to understand the analysis of the graph for liking scores, okay, for positive correlation, no relation, okay, and all that. So let's start then. Let's see, that was the first section is there. First, you are seeing a question on your screen. 10 students sit a test in two subjects, okay, math and art. The tests are marked and the percentage result is recorded in the table. Does there appear to be any link between the art and math score for each student?
No, math alag subject hai, arts alag subject hai.
No, regarding to their score, if I would like to, okay, a little bit that you can understand that, suppose that the third student would like to get the number of numbers or marks which is a multiple of 5, okay, but I don't think that indirectly they are correlated. Yeah, it's not very easy to tell. Okay, we shall draw a scatter graph to see if there is a link or not. Okay, beta. Scattering graph, that means actually scattering is the type of phenomena in which, means it's a physical, means physics concept, that is, okay, that means when the light would like to pass through the particles in the atmosphere, then those particles that would like to visible, okay, it is that type of condition. Means suppose that do you ever had gone in that type of dark room where there is no light and there is a small hole, okay, or any portion, and from that hole the sun's light is coming inside? I think that. So in that condition, then you would like to be able to see. Then in that condition, beta, you will be able to see that the particles that would like to travel into the atmosphere, clearly you will be able to see that, huh? That is known as a scattering. Scattering, you can simply understand that, suppose that with the help of scattering you are able to see any object surrounding to you. Okay. So that means a scatter graph, that we will do here. Okay, great. So beta, here you can see that 15, 87, 35, 67. So these two subject marks that are given here. So one thing that we can do, that we can assume that different subjects marks that are with respect to each other, they are just like as percent, okay? They are just like as points. So what does it mean? It means that 1587 that is given, okay? Are you able to see this red one?
Cross, red cross.
Yeah. 15, that means it will be better here. Okay. And 87. Okay. It will be 85. A little bit above that will be 87. Okay. Next is 35 67 35, that will be here. 67 that will also be in the same way over here. Okay. Okay. And next is 95, 20. So 95 that will be here and 20 that will be here, beta. Okay. Clear? And also 46. One by one that I am doing here. Wait. 46, 42, 45, 46, and 42. A little bit it will be over here. Yeah. 78, 29. 78 will be here and 29 that will be approximately here. Yes. And 5, 98. 5 is here, 98, that is approximately over here. Yeah. 29, 60, 29, 60, that will be, oh yes, here. 75, 45. Actually, that why I am placing all the points here, because that here we are understanding scatter graphs, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so that's why that okay, which one was that?
75 45 29
yeah, 75 45. Oh yes, 75 and it will be 45, that will be in middle. Yes, 62 52 is here and 52 that will be a little bit above, you can mention there. Yes. And then the last, that is 20 76 20, that is here, and 76, that is 70 75, a little bit here. That's great. Now you can see that almost that a little bit with the help of prediction that I mark all the places over there. Okay. Is there any link between the mass and the art score now?
No.
Okay, we have to draw our first scatter graph. Okay, it is your scatter graph with respect to art and math. Okay. So the first question, that is there any link between math and art score? So math and art score, a little bit. If I would like to tell you with respect to precise value of, okay, then with respect to precise value, is it okay of only red or pink?
Okay.
Okay. Your class is also recording, beta. So anytime that you can go to my channel and you can see that one, so as to practice that. And I'm requesting one thing, beta, as we are continuing after 15 days. So you just have to go to all those videos, okay, which that's are with respect to your class, so that a little bit you can revise all that which I had explained in your previous classes, okay? Yeah, that will be better for you to understand and revise all that which I had explained. Okay, so next, and they are asking that, could you describe the likely scores in art? If you knew the mass score, okay. So you can see clearly that here that all that, what is this? One way of knowing that, okay, one way of knowing that if there is a link between the math and art is answering this question, okay. What the question is? Can you draw one straight line, okay, which shows the general direction of the crosses that we plotted? Is it possible to
not
draw?
Possible.
Hold on, give me one second. Three points are there. Here, 3 points. No. I think that there are only 3 points approximately. Okay. So with the help of 3 point, you can draw graph, straight line beta, okay? Yes, it's a good line, okay? So that means it is known as the line is the, this line is called the best fit, okay? Hello. When two or three points that will be in a straight line, so that means that will be line of best fit. There is no exact answer of this line. In fact, keep trying of different lines to see how many they can vary, but it is not possible that they can vary too much, okay? And if that will not be, then yeah, you can see that. Yeah, actually that, and in that condition you are seeing that also I was relating that 2 and 3 lines. Just see that. Yeah. Oh, give me 1 second. Sorry. Actually I clicked. Oh my god. Wait a second. I am doing that quickly. Actually I clicked that 2 or 3 pictures. So do you understand that what I mean to say that they are? Yes. So there is another type of process over there. Very quickly that I can do that again here. Okay. There is another example also. 1587. It will be very quickly that I can do that. 3567. 67 over there. 9520. That is here 95 and there is 20. 46, 42, 46 and 42. There is 78, 29, 78, 29, 598, 598 and 29, 60 again, 29 and 60. So here 75, 45, 45 and then again 45 and then 62, 52 and 20, 76 and 76. Yes. So now next that this one we did that. So here beta, what I want to explain you. So one thing that when the one way that you can get there, if there is a link, then that will be correlation. And if not, miss, can you draw a straight line? Yes, we can draw a straight line. Okay, one thing that one way that you can understand that either they are interrelated or not, or correlated or not. Okay, so if you can draw a straight line which shows the general direction of the crosses, okay, that we plotted, okay? If so, then there will be a link. That means that is known as correlation, okay? If not, then the result are random and not linked, okay? That means they are known as uncorrelated, okay? So you can do one thing that you can start to draw a line as we did that before. So any line that you can draw over there, yes. So it is known as the line of best fit, okay? One more thing that, yeah, here. So line of best fit, that means that there is a correlation beta, okay? Between the math and art student, okay? If there will be a straight line with respect to 2 or 3 points which you had mentioned on your graph, okay? So clearly you have to understand that there will be a correlation, okay, between the math and art student. You can see that. Are you able to see my moving cursor?
But all marks are not in a straight line, na?
Yeah, all are not. But some are. Some are representing with respect to a straight line. That means we can say that there is a little bit correlation between math and sciences, math and art. Okay.
Okay.
Yes, yes. So, beta, correlation, that means they are not asking that all the points that should be in a straight line. No. At least minimum 3 points that should be. Because that I think that a little bit you remember that if you would like to draw a straight line on graph, so minimum 3 points that you have to take, okay? So that's why that here you are also seeing that with the help of 3 points, if you are able to draw a straight line, that means that they are correlated to each other, okay? Clear?
Yeah, give me 1 second.
And then, yeah, and now, so beta, what do you notice about the student with a high mass score and high mass score, okay, high mass score, and what do you notice about, yeah, high mass score about mass score that is approximately
96 lag raha.
Yes, 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 approximately that is, okay. What do you notice about the student with high art score, okay? Yeah. So, highest in math score, but I just see that. Highest math score, that means 100. But regarding to that, beta, highest math score, that is, means not of 100. You can see here, 95.
Math
score, that is 95, but the art score, that is 20. You know, so that means you can clearly correlate that. So a student who is getting a highest score in mathematics have the lower score in art, okay? And the student who is getting a higher art score is lower in math, that is 5, okay? Understand? Great. Are you understanding correlation, beta? It is also the type of scatter graph. Also, I explained that with the help of this topic, that line of best fit, okay? Line of best fit, if there will be 3 points regarding to which one you can draw a line, then that is known as line of best fit, and also it will explain that there will be a correlation there, okay?
But is jo line humne draw kiya isme do hi point
meet ho raha hai teen bhi ho raha hai you can see that means it is just like as example, but you can see that if you will take that one, this point and this point, then there will be 3 points there. Yes,
but agar clearly line banana ho to straight line to nahi banega, marks aise nahi hai.
Oh, bache, wait a second. Actually, if you would like to see your video, then you can see that what your eye draw here. You can, if you will draw your this point, are you able to see my moving cursor? If you will draw your line through this point, and you just see that this point, okay? 100% it will be in a straight line, you know? Yes. And also, beta, 3 points, any 3 points that you can calculate. So, 2 or 3 lines that you can draw anywhere, okay? Minimum 2 lines that you can draw that. If you see your video, then you can see that clearly that I had drawn 2 and 3 lines with the help of that pencil, which would like to appear sometimes before on this graph, okay? Yes, yes. So, you can understand from there. And then, next is, yeah, so we can say that there is a negative correlation. Why we are saying negative correlation? Because that one value is increasing, but the other value, that is decreasing, okay? You can see that we say that there is a negative correlation between the results for the math and art, okay? The better you do in one subject is less well you may do in the other one, okay? Means suppose that you are doing perfect in mathematics, but you are getting least marks in art. On the other hand, that you are also getting that maximum marks in your art, but
and least marks in maths.
So in this condition you can see that it will be your negative correlation with, okay. Do you understand that? Great. The better you do in the one subject that is less than you may do in other subject, as one result goes up and one result goes down. Okay, they are saying that can you think they are asking that can you think of any other pair of data that are negatively correlated, such as the more you eat and the less you get. Okay, so more you eat, the less hungry you are. Okay, so I think that if you are more hungry, hungry, then it is not possible to get means a maximum thing, or it is not possible to eat maximum.
Okay. Yes.
So that means the more you spend, okay, and less you save, okay, it is inversely proportional, beta. Always remember me, suppose that if your salary is 60,000, 70,000, okay. So if you will spend maximum of your salary, so it is not possible to save maximum, no. So 100% you will save less. Okay. Means suppose that I am getting 100 rupees, okay. And then 80 rupees I am spending daily. So it is not possible to spend, it is not possible to save maximum. Why? Because that if you are spending more amount, then you will save less. That's it. The less you talk, the more you think. That's the same thing. Okay. Suppose that there becomes many people who are just like as means more talkative. Okay. So, yeah, please. If they are more talkative, so regarding to that one, it is not possible for them to understand that whatever they are, they have to talk, they have to say to other person. Suppose that if I am more talkative, then without understanding, without thinking that I would like to say anything related to you randomly, okay. I will not be able to think about that, because in that condition I don't have too much time to think about that, whatever you will think about me when I would like to say something related to you.
Yes, sir.
In common language, we generally used to say like bodbak type. Sorry. Yeah. Or simply baklol bodbak here in India.
So. Ye sab UP Bihar mein bahut bolte hain.
Yeah. So what does it mean? Means suppose that if you are such kind of people, okay, if I am such kind of people, so I don't have any type of miss strategy. I don't have any type of capability to think about more and more. No. That's why that is a type of scatter values, okay? Yes. So it is also known as negative correlation, beta. Okay? So if I am more talkative, then it is not possible for me to think more. No. I will think less. Okay? So that means sometimes that means when you would like to when you would like to start to argue to your parents, okay, then sometimes that your parents would like to advise you that Priyanka, why you are arguing just like us, okay, because you are not thinking that we are your well-wisher, okay, why should I have to think less about you. So that means in that condition you can also see that if you are arguing a little bit more to your parents, so in that condition you will have the less capability to think about whatever you are arguing. Clear? Yeah.
Sir.
Yeah. So, and more, the more you revise, the less likely you will fail. Yeah. Means 100%. Means suppose that if you want to be perfect, so in that condition, and if you are revising more and more, so there will be the less possibility to fail, and you will get maximum marks in there. Okay. Are you understanding that?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Oh my God! Everything that now I'm a experiencing again that, thank God, beta. Actually, if there will be any problem, a little bit, no, I don't have to talk at this time. Okay, I'll message to you, okay? Means if you have, that is not the way to say like this. Means I, what I mean to means to say, I want to say you one thing, that if there is any type of problem, means any delay in payment or any else, beta, please don't disturb your class, okay? I can wait in that condition, okay? Please.
No,
please, beta. Priyanka, bachi, please, you are Indian. There are many foreigners who are taking classes, and some students, some foreigners are also there. Means almost 70% foreigners are there who generally used to give me payment at least in advance, okay? But at least 30-40% parents are there who generally used to give me payment in middle, okay? So I can manage all that, beta. Don't worry about that. Okay, you don't have to think about that either, whatever I will think. Yes, I am agree with that one. But main important thing, that please don't do any type of gallop or anything. If you think anything related to that one, then you can tell me that, sir, I am not giving to pay you. I am not giving your fees. Please, bear all that. Yes, sir. Yeah. Okay, so let's continue again, beta. So do you understand clearly this one, negative correlation?
Yes, sir.
Very good, beta. As usual, everything that you will also be able to understand that in your videos. And oh wow, here you can see, wow, one again, that you can see that the pencil again appear over here. So you can see one way to know that if there is a link between math and art is answering this question. What? Okay. Can you draw one straight line which shows the general direction of the crosses? Oh yes, you can see that. I am going to plot there. Give me a second. You was asking me that, sir, it is not coming with respect to 3. You can see that. Are you seeing approximately?
Haan, 3 na raha hai, sir.
Yeah, 3 it is coming. Wait, and suppose that if you would like to take other. So actually cross, that means you have to mention the middle point approximately. Okay. You can also see that here, the second line. The second line here is here. The first one, that is here. Okay. You can see that. So in that condition, 2 lines at least that you are getting over there. Okay. So wait, I am marking over here. Yes. It's a good line. You can see that there is a good line. So this 9 line are best. There is no exact answer for this line. In fact, keep trying that different lines to see that how they can vary. Okay. Hold on. A little bit that you can take like this. No, does not show the direction that crosses are traveling in. Okay, next. No, only 2 values are there, 2 lines are there. It's a line of best fit. Okay, it's, but you can see that I think that there are only 2 lines are there. Yeah. So in that way, so I think that line of best fit, their main aim was to explain you line of best fit. So that is your this one, only this one, single line. You know, that is your this line. Yes. So that's why that they are
no more lines same direction.
Yes, yes, yes. So in that condition, next about the student with high. Oh yes, that's same thing that I
same thing, same thing, sir.
Yes, yes, I can explain that to you. One result that will go up, one result that will come down. Now the next is, a student scored exactly 40 marks in their math test. Okay, 40 marks on their math test. Okay, how much are they likely to have scored in their art test? So beta, you are seeing this line or not? Okay, so you just have to do one thing, So with respect to this one, so just come on 40 and let's see that how much that it would like to score, where the line, yeah, here. Are you seeing my pointer there? I think it is 61 or 62. Hold on, 62, maybe. Yes, that's right. Understand? So that means that use the line of the best fit, which will help you that if you are getting 40 marks in mathematics. So how much would like to get in art? Okay, how much you would like to get in art? So you can draw your line perpendicular to the means parallel to the y-axis, and then you can draw the parallel to the x-axis, and where it would like to intersect the y-axis, that will be your accurate answer. Okay. In this way also, whatever type of prediction that you are doing, oh, give me one second, then you will get the accuracy over there. Okay. Understand, beta?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, give me one second, beta. I have to connect my charger. Only 1 second. 2 seconds. Thank you. Oh yes, I'm here, and thanks for your patience. Yeah, so do you understand clearly?
Yes, sir.
Great. So now come to the next one. Here the height and the hand length. Okay, the height and the hand length of 10 boys in year 8 were measured. Okay. So the results are displayed in the scatter diagram. Okay, so this type of draw the line of best fit. Line of best fit will be that line which would like to cross maximum crosses. Okay. I think that it will be like here.
Yeah.
Maybe. Yeah, that's the best one. Why? Because you can see that 4 points that are coming in a line. Okay. So it will be the line of best fit. There are several correct answer. So play around and see if you can find the other lines that's also work. Okay. So give me 1 second. Give me 1 second. 4 points are there. I don't think that any other one. No. From this point, that is not. From here, we can do that. Yes. Here you can see that 3 points that are coming in a line. No, it's not. But we did that. Okay. Wait. Just to save our time. Yeah, we can do that the same one. It is your line of best fit over here. Yeah. So that means next we can do that so that we can. Yeah. And also, they are asking that describe the correlation between the heights and the hand length. Okay, what link, if any, can you see? Yes, you can see that hand length, maximum hand length, that will have the maximum height. Okay, just see that. Maximum hand length, that is 16 centimeter, having the maximum height 15. Okay.
1.5.
That is the maximum height. Okay.
Maximum
hand length, maximum height. Okay. Minimum
hand
length. Minimum
correlation.
Yeah.
Then it becomes positive correlation.
Yeah, you're right. Fantastic. Yeah. You can see that. Yes. I click after. But you tell me your answer before. Yeah, the bigger your means which will be better. You can also understand that which will be directly proportional, that will be your positive correlation. That means if one is increasing, the other will also increase. And in which one that you will get that means inversely proportional, then that will be your negative correlation. Understand?
Mm-hmm.
Great. Okay. Yeah. Use the line to estimate the hand length of a boy with a height of 1.33 1.3 30 height 1.3 1.3 is here 1.4 is here. Sometimes the student would like to confuse there, but you can also understand in this way, 1 point, you can convert that into equivalent form. So just like as 1.30 1.40, so approximately it will be here. And then you can okay, wait, hold on. No, I think that it will be 13.
Okay? 13.
Yeah, 13. I can see that. Yeah, are you seeing my moving cursor? Means here 1.33. It will be 1.33. That will be here. And then it will be, when it will be cross over here, and then it will be 13. Okay, so you can place the value over there, like 13. Oh, please, 13. Let's mark it. Yeah, that's a perfect. Okay. Yes. Again, we can start making two. Yes. Do you understand it? Great. Very good, beta. So now, wow. So, beta, this type of scattering graph that will come in your exam. Yes. Scattering graph, scattering correlation, positive correlation, negative correlation, means they will not give you that either there is positive correlation or negative. Simply, you have to understand there of seeing that scattering graph that either that is positive correlation there is or either negative correlation. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
They will not give you. You just have to assume by yourself.
Mm.
Okay. So the weight of the 10 children were measured and plotted against the number of hours they watched TV in a day. The results are displayed in the scatter diagram. Okay. Draw the line of best fit. So line of best fit, that means the line which would like to pass minimum of 3 points, okay? I think
Between 40 and 45.
Yes. Oh my god. Line of best fit. No, it is not. No. I think a little bit we can do like this. I think yes. No, Peter, you know that none of that one is coming perfectly, you know. No, only two lines are coming too. Yeah, so no. Here, no. Oh my god, a little bit we can assume. Wait, hold on. I am trying this one again. Let me, but oh yes, you can see that also. It is not. Yeah, it's a not. So you can see that, beta, the crosses have no directions, okay. Hence, there is not a link between the someone's weight and the number of hours when they watch TV. So that is, there is not a correlation, beta. Okay.
There is no correlation. Unrelated, uncorrelated.
Yeah, uncorrelated. No correlation or uncorrelation. You can say any else. Understand, beta? A little bit I was thinking that here it will be correlation, but then when I draw the line,
between
then you can see that only two crosses that are in a line, but the third one that is a little bit away from it. Okay, so now next is, wow. So what is summary? Summary is that So it's a negative correlation. Okay, it is negative correlation. Negative correlation, that means one value is increased, other value is decreased. Clear? I'll also send this one, this picture to you, and also that video you will be able to see at any time. Okay, so give me 1 second, I am sending it to you very quickly. Once again, yeah, I send that to you. And now, so that means beta, negative, that means inversely proportional. Okay, positive, that means directly proportional. Okay, more to more. Okay, more to more. Yeah, why they are giving buttons? That's here, right? Oh, as one value goes up and the other value goes down, the data values move in opposite direction. Okay, so that's why statistic, that will be negatively correlated. Okay. Yeah, I'm not sending this one because that when you will see your video, then 100% you will be able to understand. And secondly, here of the second one, you can see that as the value of hand length that is increasing, with respect to that one, the value of height is also increasing. So it's a directly proportional. That's why that it will be positive correlation. Okay. Or means you can say that positively correlated. Secondly, the third one, that means so when there will be not a type of, means a connection between the three points or three crosses over there. Okay. That's why that the statistic have no link whatsoever. Okay. So no link, that will be no line that we can measure with respect to best fit. That's why that there will be no correlation over there. Okay. Understand, beta? Great. Now come the last one. Exam question. Okay. Oh, no problem. So that means foot size and height. Suppose that this type of question they will give you. Okay. So within 5-10 minutes that we can do that quickly. They are asking that draw the line of best fit. How tall would you expect someone with the size 7 feet? Okay, that's great. Extend your graph to find out how tall someone with the size of 14 feet may be. Okay. Oh, wow. So here you can see that when you will, firstly you have to draw your scatter graph. Whatever data that is given, so regarding to that one, scatter graph that you have to get there. Now they are asking that what will be the size of 7 feet. Okay, what will be the height of 7 feet size? 7 foot. Okay, size. So 7, you have to, that is here, you have to draw perpendicular and then you have to draw this one. So it, then you can see that it will be 170 centimeter. Okay, again they are asking that when the size that will be 15 foot, then what will be its height? So 114 feet, and then it will be about 220 to 230, so I think 226 or 227 that will be. Okay. 226, you can see here. Understand? So it was your scatter graphs, beta, and simple correlation. Do you understand clearly? That's great. Now next is your line of best fit. Okay, so again that in separate way they are also explaining line of best fit. Okay, so I think that it will not take too much time to, so you will understand very clearly. Drawing of line of best fit, as I explained that to you in your previous section, that line of best fit, that will be that line which would like to pass at least three minimum crosses, okay, or points. Okay. So also we would like to be finding the equation of line of the best fit. Oh my god, what is this equation of line? Oh my god, Priyanka, here we will study about to find a little bit gradient and slope intercept. Oh, it's a statistic But now here, yeah, you can see that it's a statistic that we are studying. Okay, no problem. Don't worry about that one. I'll explain that for you. Yes, yes. So, and also that we would like to understand about the interpolation and extrapolation, interpolating gradient and intercept. I will explain you that in easy way, that how do you get your gradient and intercept over there. Okay. Yeah, prior knowledge that is scatter graph and y equals to mx plus c. But whatever you are seeing, that y equals to mx plus c, it is your general equation of line, okay? I don't think that when you was in your 10th grade, that at that time, that whatever that you had studied in your geometry, I think 100% that you had taken knowledge of that straight line over there. But I don't think that this time that you remind that or you remember all that. So, no problem. Yes, yes, yes. So here that I mean to say that, just keep that in your mind, that y equals to mx plus u. Actually, you know that, if I would like to teach a little bit to my science stream student, okay, then it will not be a difficulty to explain each and everything, okay? But as you said, of being a bio student, so that's why that it sometimes that I feel a little bit that, oh my god, that how I will prepare all that to her, how is it possible to explain each and everything? So that's the main thing. That's why I am choosing this type of online book. Yes, here you can see that a lot of variation, there is a lot of different type of questions. Yeah, and also the same type of question that you will see that in your book, which you have manually in your manual book. Okay, so but let's start that. Oh my god, 2 or 3 minutes are remaining, so let's do that a little bit. Okay, here is a scatter graph showing the result of math and art. Great. Oh my god, so here that line of best fit you can understand clearly. Great. We need to draw the line of best fit. Yes, but where the pencil will appear? The line of best fit has two features, okay? What? It shows the general direction of crosses. Yes, that's right. You know that what is the general direction of crosses? General direction beta, that means it is in this side, it is in this direction, it is in this direction. So when, if you are taking in this direction, so the line would like to pass through in this same direction, okay? If you are taking the other direction, so that will also be in the other direction. That means indirectly they are explaining that when you would like to combine all the crosses, then their direction that would like to be same, okay? Yeah. So that means it would like to pass through the mean point. That means where? That means intersecting point, middle point, middle intersecting point of all the crosses, okay? Yeah, this is slightly different from where, from what you do in CGSC math, so be careful, okay? Beta, the same thing that they are taking this one.
Same thing, sir.
Yeah, same data that they are taking, so that is best for understanding that. Oh my god, the total of 10 mass marks is this, so what, and the mean marks. Mean mass marks is 46. Find the mean marks of art. So what you have to do here, you just have to add all that, and then you have to take average of that one. That's it. You know that how to get average? But just to take average, you just have to add
and divide by total number.
Yeah, total number. Oh, that's great. That's right. So I think that first section that we did here, beta. So I think that you told me to take class Monday, Tuesday and Thursday, huh?
Sir, Thursday mera Tuesday nahi hoga, sir. Thursday karte hain. Thursday and Friday.
Okay. Okay, no problem, beta. Yeah, you are telling me. So I will. I will schedule your class on Thursday, and before scheduling class, I will ask you in morning. Okay. I hope you understand and enjoy today's class, beta. Correlation and scattering, and you fully understand that within few hours that you will see your class video on my channel. Please like and subscribe if you didn't do that, and also if you will promote my channel, I will be really appreciated of that. So thanks for today, beta. Have a great time and greetings to your parents. Thank you. Bye bye.
Thank you, sir.